This is Bishop Turner with All Lives Matter tonight. I want to come to you and share with you tonight some of the stuff we got going on. And we want you to be involved tonight as we open up doors, body, mind, soul, and spirit, as we go to the internet, as we call our ancestor to us. And that's Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael, and all the archangels. I'm going to bring to you. Tonight, as I bring them to you, I open up doors to your healing. And I'm talking about clairvoyant healing tonight. As I talk about some things that's going on tonight, I want to share with you. The names of Michael Raphael. We are family. We will stay together. This All Lives Matter tonight. And this segment to deal with the drugs and the dope and what's going on in the community as we light up the way. America is full of drugs and alcohol, and we must deal with that as the ancestors, as I hold up the ancestors, as I invoke the angel of healing to you tonight. I'm praying to you, Purvis Spam. Happy birthday to you. I'm praying for you. And those who got a birthday in this month, Brother Jahi, happy birthday to you. And we want to let you know, healing and deliverance will come. I want to invoke two angels. I want to invoke the angel Michael, Archangel Michael. And I want to invite the angel Gabriel. Also, I invite the angel Raphael. Now, as I invite them into your home, open up doors to you as they go forth to heal and deliver you. I'm praying for your healing right now. I'm praying for the angel Michael Raphael to go to you. And as they go to break yoke for you, I go for them to heal body, mind, soul, and spirit. I want to come to you and tell you the angel at the top is Michael, Gabriel, and Metatron, and that's the Ark of the Covenant. That's the Rooster, Year of the Rooster. And then we're getting ready on the 21st for the Lunar, the Eclipse. And those are energies from the Almighty. I want to share that with you, so you be a part of that. I want you to read Psalm 119. I want you to get ready for God to deliver you. Get ready for doors open up for you. I'm praying for you and you tonight. As I reach out to you, Kelly, I'm praying for you. Mag, I'm praying for you. I want to let you know, Sister Pat Cox, I'm praying for you. Down in Yazoo City, Mother Love, I'm praying for you in Yazoo City. I'm praying for you down in Jasper, Alabama, Sister Jean. I'm praying for you, Brother Lewis, right down in Carbon Hill, Alabama, and a young lady in Shelton, Alabama, those that in that movement in all throughout the South, we're praying for you in Birmingham. God is able to do a blessing. I'm praying for you, Sister Marcella. And as you know, God is able to open the door for you. I want to share with you the breakthrough of the angels. And when I the breakthrough of the angels to come to break the yoke. I just wanted to share that with you tonight as we get ready to break the yoke. As we get ready to come into this month, the month of August, Amiel is the God and Angel this month, along with Archangel Michael. I want you to get ready for the door to open up for you. I want you to know that all lives matter to God, wherever it might be. We're praying for the people over in France, people over in London, and those that was in the car accident. We're praying for them today. And we're praying for you and the blessing for you that God opened the door for you. And I want to share with you tonight the key to unlock doors for you. God will make you supply. We're the seed of Abraham, blessing out of favor. Get ready for God to bless you. He said, Abraham, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to change your name from Abraham to Abraham. I'll bring you from these. I'm going to bless your seed. We are the seed of Abraham, blessing highly favored. So the blessing of Abraham is on you. The blessing of God is on you. And you need to walk in the anointing. Somebody said, praise God. Somebody said, glory, hallelujah. I can feel the spirit of Bishop Mason tonight. And I feel the spirit also of Bishop Poole tonight. And I feel the spirit of some of the old preachers that fought Bishop J.L. Clark, and we're praying for those that come in. We are family, and we have to stay like family and stay focused as a family. Be focused tonight. Philippians 4:19, Matthew 6:33, St. Luke 6:38, and also Mark 11:29. I want you to get ready as a family, and the rooster represents family, and the rooster crowed, you know, when they lied, the rooster crowed. So I want to tell you, your healing is on its way. I'm praying for you tonight, wherever you might be, and I want to talk about those 10 commandments tonight, where you might be part. Sister, I'm praying for you, Reverend Bailey in Chicago. Sister Bailey in Greenwood, Mississippi, I'm praying for you and your family. All is well tonight. I'm going to share some things with you tonight. Those that want my book, this is how it looks. You can tell Bishop, I want this book, Prophecy for 2017. On the back, we're going to the Egypt, to the pyramid. So you want the book, I got the book. I got prophecy in the book. Some of the stuff in the book is prophecy to open up doors for you. So it's important for you to come involved in my book and be involved in what you want God to do for you, because God can definitely open a door for you and God can break a yoke for you. I want you to get ready. Those that want God to do something for them, and I think God really wants to open up the door for you, and you need to be able to receive the blessing of God and what God got for you, and the door that will open up for you. I believe that God got a special door for you. I want you to receive the blessing of God working for you today and working in a special way. So every door closed will be opened up, and I want you to get ready at this hour. I'm praying for 50-50. Call me. I want you to know all the way up. All lives matter to God. And I want to let you know there's no color in God. God is the God of the universe. He is the God of all men. He is the creator, and the reason you can't touch God is because you are a sinner, not saved, and won't become give up. The preacher's got to do more than just preach on Sunday. They got to get out and go into the highways and the byways and tell men to come to God. It ain't been done. We got away from that, and we need to understand that what God doing tonight. I want to share some things with you very personally tonight, and this is Sister Slade saying that it's time for us to get ourselves together and understand what God got for you. I'm praying for you tonight, and I want you to know all is well tonight. And I want you to get ready. I'm going to give you some of the prophecy that will be tornadoes back to back. There will be 12 hurricanes coming from on the ocean. That's going to happen. There also will be an upswing in in the White House, things gonna be brought out. They just stopped the terrorist attack and got another book. And about storms and flood coming in the book. So I got it in the book tonight. I want you to have the book. And I want to let you know the seed of Abraham prophecy for 2017. I want you to have that. And some of the things that we're going to share with you is in this book. And I'm praying for you, Sister Ross in Detroit. I'm also praying for you, Sister Maddie from Washington, D.C. Every letter, every telephone call, I'm praying for you that have called me. And I want to let you know God is able to do things before. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, God bless all the people all over the world. Bring them back to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, over the name of Jesus, touch every man, every woman, every boy and girl. Open up the door for them where they might be into what God got for them. And I want you to be able to touch, heal, and deliver right now. So God got a blessing. Don't forget the book. Don't forget the book. I'm praying for you, you and you. Every letter, all life now to God. It seems like our young folks don't value life. And the best thing you got is your life. And your life will be even Stevenson. And I want to say it to you, in the spirit of all the saints of God, and the spirit of all the people of God, I'm praying for you and you today, and whatever you might be, I'm praying for you, Sister Hattie. I'm praying for you, Sister Hope, Miss T. I'm praying for you. Every letter, every telephone call, I'm praying for you, Sister Lois, that everything will work out. And I want to tell you, every telephone call, every letter, I'm praying for you in Yazoo City. I'm praying for you in Canton, Mississippi. I'm praying for you in Durant. And I'm also praying for you in Holmes County, Mississippi. One of the richest counties in the state of Mississippi is Holmes County. And by the way, it was a black county. I want to share that with you. They weren't begging. They weren't sharecropping. Those people had money, cars, and living a good life. I just want to share that with you, so you might know that that's what was going on. God bless you tonight. This is Bishop Turner Block Talk Radio. All lives matter tonight. Those that call me, those that want to get in contact with me, I want you to see this. This is our prophecy book of 2017. Some of you have it. Some of you audit. Some of you didn't get it. I want you to continue stay in the will of God. I'm praying for you down in Jackson, Mississippi. I'm praying for those who call me. And I want to let you know, thank you, Mother Love. Mother Love was telling me about her dinner she had and about how she wanted me to pray. And I want to let you know, Mother Love, I'm praying for you. And I'm praying for many of you. I was talking last night, all lives matter. And the killing that just happened where 13 people was killed, I think 100 were injured, where they come through there with a car and hit people, and what happened in Virginia. We praying for the family. There's no sorrow on earth that heaven cannot hear. I want you to get ready for God to deliver your son, your daughter, for God will deliver your family. And I want you to know God is able to do anything, but there's no failure in God. Happy birthday to Purvis Spann, the president and the owner of WVON. And he's a legend. He started VON from scratch. He was with Leonard Chess. And I want to say happy birthday to him, Purvis Spann. I've been a little sick. Bishop, I'm praying for you. Bishop Cook, down in New Orleans, things are right. And Reverend Clay Everett, I'm praying for you at Fellowship Church. I'm praying that everything be all right. You've been a little sick. Reverend Clay Everett, we're praying for Reverend Clay Everett of Fellowship Baptist Church, one of the larger churches in Chicago, one of the churches that brought Dr. King to town. Reverend Cleveland brought Dr. King to town when everybody, other preachers, wouldn't even let Dr. King come in their pulpit. But Reverend Cleveland brought Dr. King to town. Purpose Band, let Dr. King talk on this radio show. I want to honor these great black men for their lives. Reverend Clay Evans, they've sung all over the world. Purpose Band, his station, the Jackson 5, all the gospel singers and all the blues singers come to WVON. And I want to let you know, Purpose Band is the founder of WVON. He started WVON. I want to say happy birthday to Purpose Band and his family, the Span family. And I want to say it to you, all is well. Brother Darrell, God bless you. You're doing a good job taking care of your father. We can continue to pray for you, the Span family of WBON. One of the stations, the black stations, that stayed black in the city of Chicago and talked about voting and all of that and talked about All Lives Matter. And I want to tell you tonight, all lives matter to God. Let me say it again. All lives matter to God. Whatever you're going through tonight, put God first on your agenda. And if you can put God first on your agenda, on your agenda, God will open up a door for you. I'm praying for you and you tonight, and I want you to know that God is able to bless you. If you got a need, you plant a seed and have a ministry, and God will bless you. Some of you, I want to let you know that God, all lives matter. Do you see what's going on over in Paris and France and all over in across the water? And Trump had the nerve to get up and say, "We with you." How come he didn't talk about what happened in Virginia, what a terrorist Ku Klux Klan ran and killed that woman and hurt them people? He didn't talk about that. He talked about something across the sea. He got to take care of what's going on at home. If he ain't taking care of what's going on, he can shut his mouth. You know, and everybody in that cabinet, they lie. So I ain't got no problem to say if the Republican don't do nothing and the Democrats don't do nothing, we in a sick situation. But I pray and I decree that all life matter to God. And God told Jeremiah, prophesied the word of God. God told Jeremiah, said, decree some things. You can't decree nothing when you ain't living nothing. Some of you are full of alcohol. Yeah, I'm going to say, thank you, Holy Ghost. Some of you are full of drugs. Thank you, Holy Ghost. And I want to tell you, until you straighten out your life, you can't straighten out nobody else's life. I'm picking up Bishop Mason of the Church of God in Christ. And also, Bishop Mason is sitting here in the spirit world, and also Bishop Ford. And they've been on me all day. I'm trying to wait till I cross over. But the word they're speaking, I got to tell you tonight. There's a bishop, our ministers, is not going outside the church to bring these people off of dope and drugs. If you buy some shoes for yourself, what are you going to buy some for somebody ain't got none? We're too selfish. We're caught up in the system, in the white man's system, that we full of greed. And you know, our young football players and basketball players, they want to be like white folks. They ain't got no desire to help the young blacks coming up. So the young blacks coming up, they stealing cars. It show you that they dumb. What you gonna steal a car that ain't got no gas in it? And you gonna steal a car, it got a GPS, gonna cut it off after go a mile, but you steal it and go to jail or get shot. Or the police stop and you stole a car, they'll shoot you. Okay? And what I'm saying, there's an evil spirit, I'm gonna say this to y'all, there's an evil spirit that's on our young folks, and the pastors and the pastors and the ministers of the church is not trying to get it off of them. Matter of fact, community organization, you know, I'm homeless, you know, and the thing of it is an evil spirit, people. The jailhouse, it's more people in prison right now, as I speak, than it was in slavery. It's more people in jail now. And the spirit of murder is among us. Ain't no white folks killing us. The Ku Klux Klan said we're going to lay back and let black folks kill black folks. Because we putting the dope out there. We putting the guns out there. And we doing stuff to mess with them. And it's happening. Right before our eyes. Your son is not safe going to school. Your daughter is not safe. Until you understand that we got to pray and bring the spirit of God back into our homes, into our family. See, you got women's, now God, I'm going to pray for you. You got women's on dope, and they got crack babies because the dad is on dope. So you done had a crack baby. That crack baby don't care about nothing but more dope, and by any means necessary. What's going on in America? What it got to do with you? Tonight, I'm going to tell you all lives matter. But the devil come to kill and destroy. The devil come to take your life. That's what's his job. And he don't care about what color. You got more white folks on dope and cocaine than black folks. But you got a whole generation, I mean, you don't want to hear, on drugs. They on crack, cocaine, alcohol. They on all kind of drugs. So what they think about life is nothing, because until they stop, the only way to clean them up, they have to come off of dope, that poison, come off of alcohol, poison, come out of all the stuff that destroying the mind and the body. Here was a white boy going to court. He OD'd in the courtroom, because before he left, he took some crack and cocaine and some pills, and he collapsed. Right there in the courtroom, they had to give him a shot, the locks or something. They gave him a shot to bring him back. But what if you ain't around nobody to give you the shot? You're going to die and go to hell, because the wages of sin is death. The gift of God, eternal life. I know y'all don't want to hear this, but all lives matter to God. I want you to know that tonight. Until you get ready to ask God for deliverance for your children, for you. And I want to share this with you tonight. I got something I want to share. The Ten Commandments is that, and I got the Ten Commandments right here. And it's, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not. God gave these Ten Commandments to Moses. He said, Moses, put these commandments in the Ark of the Covenant and take the rod that you parted the water, put it in the Ark of the Covenant, and take this manna come from heaven, put it in the Ark of the Covenant as a reminder that I'm present. And I want to tell you tonight, God is still present in your life. I'm praying for you, you and you. And I want to let you know God is able. That young lady got a son in jail. That mother got a daughter on drugs. You don't know what to do. I'm going to tell you what to do. Prayer changes things. I just need somebody that want to pray. A young lady called me from Yazoo City to tell me they want to give her son 30 years for walking in a store with some boys, and the boys stuck up the store. He just happened to be in the store. Because he's black, he was part of the thing. See what I'm saying? They want to give all them young men 30 years apiece, and the lawyer is going along with it. No justice, no peace. See, what I'm saying to you, somebody got to care. And I'm right now, I'm talking about just judge. The just judge. I got the call on the just judge. I got the call on Michael. I got the call on the archangels to go forth and fight against this evil spirit and put on a black robe and say, I'm a judge. And went to school and said, I'm the DA. And trying to send all of God's people to prison for a long time. 40, that's just like slavery. It's a boy 16, they want to give him 30 years. Here's the boy 12. They want to give him 30 years. When he get out of here, grown man, just because somebody walked in a store and somebody, you know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying, all lives matter to God. All the killing that's going on, I'm praying for the family. The boy was playing ball. They come up and shot him in the head, dead. You know white folks do that. Black young teenagers did that. They're sick. They're full of drugs. And they are walking demons. I rebuke the demons because they're going to die. What you put on somebody else is coming back to you. The Bible said the wages of sin is death. The gift of God, eternal life. And it says, shake down, press together, run it over. God give to the bosom. If you give, you're going to get back. If you don't give, you ain't going to get nothing back. And the 10th commandment was given to Moses to give to us. And we're still living by the 10th commandment. But we have strayed away. When I say we, as a generation, we have strayed away from God. There's a divine law where God said, Adam and Eve. He said, man and woman. When you stray away from God's law, you know what's going to happen? You're going to die. Your children are going to die. Your family are going to die. You're dead. Take a fish out of the water, he died. And I want to tell you, some of you is out the water, you're in sin, up to your neck. New car, new home, money in the bank can't save you. Only thing I'll say is repent to the Almighty God. When you repent, God can heal the diseases, the curse that's been put on your family, the curse been put on your daughter, the curse that's been put on your family. All lives matter to God. I wish I had somebody know what I'm talking about. Tonight, I want to take the curse off of your family. I want to take the curse off of your child that's in prison. Don't know why he's there. That demon had told him. And you might not believe it. The crack cocaine is nothing but a slow death. And do you know we got a whole generation of drug addicts? Black, white, in the suburbs, all over. His show is bad. Yeah, it's bad. Because ain't nobody rebuked the drugs. You know? What we gonna do? We gonna pray. Police can't stop it. The army can't stop it. Nobody but God can stop it. Y'all don't want to hear me. Because some of you done strayed away from God. You don't want to hear nothing about God. And you got preachers homosexual. You got preachers raping girls and raping little boys in the Catholic Church, in the Baptist Church. In all the religion, they are killing children. The wages of sin is death. The gift of God, eternal life. I want you to wake up and begin to pray. I want you to wake up. You said an eclipse coming on. That happened Monday. I'm going to talk a little bit about that. So you got to understand all Venus, Mars, and Saturn belongs to angels. The angels control the universe. Micah gave me. So when that eclipse comes, it's going to become totally darkness. It's going to get cold. That's God moving on the planet, trying to destroy some of this evil been put out there. Do you know the wages of sin is death, the gift of God, eternal life, all lives matter to God, wherever it might be? Not only just in Chicago, but in America, we got a drug problem. And the mayor ain't said nothing. The president ain't said nothing. The president put a bill together to stop people. You can't put no bill. You got to go in the streets, preachers. You got to go in the streets, missionary. You got to see people where they're at and pray for them and rebuke that drug demon in the jails. Homosexuality going on in jail. They getting dope and drugs in jail. The county jail just had a boy had a pistol in the jail. How did he get a pistol between all of them? All they bringing dope and crack into what I want to say to you tonight, people. The reason so much killing going on, it's because of drugs, because of demon spirits. They carry demon spirits. And the Bible said, fret not thyself, evildoers, they'll soon be cut down. I don't care how many guns you get, how many guards you get, nothing but prayer can change this thing. All lives matter to God. Not just black life, not just white life, all matter. God created man and woman to be fruitful and multiply. God is able for you all to love. But God so loved the world, he gave it only to God's son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. I want you to get ready to live, not to die. God wants you to live. The devil comes to kill and destroy and confusing you. When you go to St. John 8, I want you to get this. St. John, go to John 8 and 44. The devil is a liar. He is a liar. And the truth ain't in him. Unto you plead the blood of Jesus tonight. God told me, well, bitch, I got rheumatism. I'm smoking these reefers. Rheumatism. Well, you saying the rheumatism is so strong that it's over God? You say, I got cancer. I got to go get radiation. You don't trust God enough to have him to heal you? I got to go to the doctor. God is the divine doctor, but you ain't got enough faith in God to receive your healing tonight because you caught up in the world. You can't be in the world. You got to come out of the world and be on one accord. That's Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. There's no failure in God. God is a win-win situation. I plead the blood of Jesus tonight on you that's an alcoholic. And you saying, you lying, saying you ain't, but you're alcoholic. You might be a doctor, lawyer. You might be a professor at school. And I want to plead the blood of Jesus on them that are caught up on crack, cocaine. They can't shake it by themselves. But I want to tell you tonight, the blood of Jesus cover you. You that caught up and seem like the devil is choking you out. And you seeing your family die, your sister, your brother, being shot down, run over by car. That's the devil. What's happening is the work of the devil. Did you see all the men with them torches? That's the devil trying to bring light to darkness. The devil can't bring no light to darkness. Can't nobody bring light to God, to darkness, but God. Because God is the light of the world. In all thy ways acknowledge God, he will direct your path. All lives matter to God tonight. I want to tell you that. All lives matter to God. I want you to get ready and let somebody know all lives matter to God.